when you're working on FamilySearch, do you ever find a mistake in gender, which makes it very difficult to merge two people together? Howdy, I'm Devin Noel Lee with Family History Fanatics. If this is your first time here, we hope you enjoy the videos you see about DNA, about genealogy, and more. We hope to help you learn how to climb your family tree further, faster, and have a whole lot of fun along the way. In genealogical research, mistakes happen. But what happens when you discover that, you know what? Two individuals with the exact same name, only modified slightly for gender, really are the same person, and we need to fix them in our family's tree for the ancestors from the past. In the case of Winfield Underwood, subject of the Research Over My Shoulders series for some time now, he had a Lorenza Duggins and a Lorenzo Underwood. What's going on? When we look at Lorenzo's profile, you quickly see there's no sources attached. What is going on? We'll come back to that in a second. Now let's go over and see if this Lorenzo Duggins is supposed to be with this family. When you look at her sources, you do see the evidence that her maiden name was Underwood. So one tip that you have to pay attention to when you're putting families together and identifying the names of individuals, when it comes to women, would you please just use their maiden surnames and not their married names? It creates a lot of confusion, and some unsuspecting or novice genealogists might have taken Lorenzo Duggins out of the family without a second thought. Her maiden name, the surname at the time of her birth was Underwood, and that's the one we need to use. But what happens if you don't know what her maiden name is? Then leave it blank. When you do switch her surname from Duggins to Underwood, that triggers FamilySearch to not only just look for hints for Duggins, it will also look for hints for Underwood. Now that Lorenzo Underwood is accurate, it's time to try to figure out how did we come up with the Lorenzo Underwood for this family? Well, on FamilySearch, you can be on a person's profile page, a person page, and click FamilySearch, and it will take you to the search side of FamilySearch and away from the tree side of the page. So now that we're in the research results section, you can see up at the top that we're trying to look for Lorenzo, and all of a sudden you see a census record. So in this case, we see a Lorenzo Underwood. Now, how do we know this is the right person and the right family? It could be somebody else entirely. Now, if you've seen any of the Research Over My Shoulders series, you know that Nancy stayed behind with her children while her husband Hiram and her son Clinton and Winfield went to Grayson County, Kentucky to prepare for the family to move there. So Nancy stays behind with a whole lot of children. So the first thing we need to decide is if this record for Lorenzo and all of these siblings, as well as a mother named Nancy, fits our family. And sure enough, if we go back to the FamilySearch profile that I've been working on and cleaning up, we see all of the same siblings, Julia and who else do we have? Flora and Eliza and Henry. So that matches. This record is about Nancy and the children that stayed behind in Kentucky while her husband moved to Texas. One of the things that you have to learn in genealogy is we want to always go look at original records. So now let's look at the original document, just like I said. We need to look at the original record and figure out how the heck do we have a Lorenzo but not a Lorenza. Take a look. So enumerators are not perfect. They often made copies of copies, and we never know who answered the door. So in 1880, we have this family, and we have a Lorenzo. That name is clearly Lorenzo, whose gender is female, But in the relationship to the household column, Lorenzo is listed as a son. That's what those ditto marks are all about. The ditto marks is for son, not daughter. So the indexer cannot be faulted. They had to pick whether this female named Lorenzo, who's a son, is really a mistaken gender, should have been male, or what if the child really was female and the other two messed up? That's not for the indexer to make that determination. So the fault lies probably with the enumerator or the family getting things all mixed up. But here's the deal. There is no other evidence that Nancy and her family had a Lorenzo. None. But this is the only time Lorenza is not in the family. Yeah, there was a mistake. And it's highly likely Lorenza is really Lorenzo in this record, and she was female, so that the gender was right, even though it should have said Lorenzo, a daughter. Okay, we can make that case because, again, this is 1880. How do we fix it in the FamilySearch family tree? Because, again, this is a collaborative tree. What we do affects what other people see. Well, the first thing we need to do is go to the Lorenzo profile, because you cannot merge a male profile and a female profile. FamilySearch doesn't let you. So you have to change Lorenzo to Lorenza, and you just change it here with gender. And of course, even though I'm not doing it right now, make a reason statement. Talk about how that you believe that this record was inaccurate based on additional evidence that there was a Lorenza, not a Lorenzo, and she lived into adulthood from this family. As we did in a previous video with Birdie, we'll simply merge Lorenza, the two Lorenzas, keeping the information that is pertinent and leaving, excluding the rest of the information that is unnecessary. So there you have it. That's how you can merge a case of misidentified gender for your ancestors in the past on FamilySearch. If you have any other questions on how to fix problems that you find on FamilySearch, be sure to put them in the comments below. Once again, I'm Devin Noel Lee, and this is Family History Fanatics, where we are more than just a YouTube channel. We coordinated e-conferences, webinars, have on-demand products, as well as books. Be sure to check those out at www.familyhistoryfanatics.com. It will also take you to our blog at blog.familyhistoryfanatics.com, and when you sign up for our newsletter, you'll get this handy e-guide totally for free, and this helps you never miss another episode, because sometimes hitting subscribe and the bell, which we really hope you will do, doesn't always let you know when a new video is released, but our newsletter will never fail you.